I'm Paul in Thailand. This video is for Ms. Ford and her school pupils in 6th grade in New Jersey, USA, especially Michaela, Elise, Leah and Matt. Ms. Ford, thanks so much for such a heartwarming message. I'd like to say a big thanks to you and your class for taking an interest in the elephant and piano videos in social studies. You asked how often I play to elephants. Well, I have a little house at Elephant's World and a studio in Bangkok. The elephants live about 3.5 hours drive from our city home. We come to see the elephants often and play a little music on each visit. A few months ago, I played piano for one of the oldest elephants in Thailand. Her name was Nong Mai, which means new arrival in Thai. It's thought she was born around 1930, so she was somewhere around 84 to 80 years old. Elephants can live to be about 70 years old in the wild, as Nong Mai was well cared for. She became an exceptionally old elephant. Ms. Ford told me you're reading together the excellent book, The One and Only Ivan. It's a great book. Well, the elephants that live at Elephant's World here all have similar past lives to Ivan and Stella. We have an elephant here called Marley. She got hit by a lorry which broke her back legs. My wife Quan has made a sculpture of Marley. So she's a bit like Stella that had an injury to her leg too. And like Stella, Marley wanted to live with wide open spaces around her. And at Elephant's World, we made her dream come true. In Thailand, we have wild elephants in national parks and domesticated elephants which live in elephant parks. All domesticated elephants have a mahout, which is a person with a special skill and understanding of elephants, and they spend their life looking after the needs of just one elephant. Elephants eat a tenth of their body weight each day, so that's about 200 kilos of food each day. So that's a lot of food to plant, cut and bring to the elephants. Elephants drink a lot of water, so they need to live close by a river. A few months ago, we had a baby elephant born here at Elephant's World. I spent a few days and nights waiting with my camera for the moment to arrive, and she might remind you of Ruby in your story. Our elephant has got bigger very fast, as you can see, and we call her Norgel. Luckily for elephants, we have Dr. Erica Ward living in Thailand. Erica is a vet originally from Michigan, USA, so around 650 miles from your school in New Jersey. But today, Erica is 8,000 miles away in Chiang Mai, looking after animals. Erica is a real expert in elephant care, and I'll pass you over to her as she wants to talk to you about elephants. So, goodbye from all of us here in Thailand, and good luck with all you are doing.
Hi, I'm Dr. Erica Ward. I'm an elephant vet, and I'm here at Elephant's World in Thailand. I'm here with Gaina, Tommy, and Boon Rung, and their mahout, Johnny, Happy, and Klahan. Elephants are very famous for their trunk. It's very strong. They use it for many things like eating, blowing on themselves. They suck up water and cool themselves down. They drink water with it. They rip their food with it. Many, many things. It's full of hundreds of thousands of muscles, and they have two big nostrils just like we do, but they go all the way up to the top. Asian elephants have one finger on the tip of their trunk, just like we have a finger, and a palm on the bottom, like this. African elephant trunks look a lot different. They have one finger on the top and one finger on the bottom. Elephants have these great big ears, and they're kind of shaped like the country India. And the elephants have such big ears to help cool their bodies down. So elephants don't have any sweat glands on them. Instead, they use water that they get from the ground, or they spit into their trunk, and they'll blow it on themselves, and that helps cool them down, just like when we sweat. They have a lot of blood vessels that run on the back and on the front of their ear, especially on the back. And when it gets really hot, the blood will flow through their ears, and then flapping them back and forth helps them cool down. Elephants have very big leg bones, both in their front legs and their back legs. And their whole body is designed kind of like a table. So it looks a lot different than some of the other animals we're used to seeing, like dogs and cats and horses. Their legs have, their bottom of their feet have a fat cushion in the back right here. So they have all their toe bones and then a big fat cushion in the back here. And as they step down, their foot expands and all of the weight gets spread across. And then when they lift their foot up, it acts like a pogo stick and actually helps propel them forward. It's pretty cool. And the acoustic fat that's found in their feet, they can also hear a lot of vibrations. They can hear vibrations both in their feet and with their very big ears, they can hear sounds from very far away, just like a big funnel to help get the sound into their eardrum. And now here we get to see Tammy's tail. She has very, very thick hair on the bottom of her tail. And as you can see, she's waving it back and forth. She does that to help keep the flies off of her body. It acts as a really big fly swatter. Elephants have kind of small eyes for their body size, and their eyesight isn't very good either. They can see some distance in front of them, but they can't see anything right in front of them like this, anything right behind them, and anything too far back like this. Elephants are pregnant for longer than any other mammal. Usually they're pregnant for 18 to 22 months. That's a very long time. Elephants eat for many, many hours of the day and night. They only sleep for about 4 hours and they spend most of the rest of their time grazing for food. They love to eat grasses and corn stalks and all sorts of barks and trees and roots. They usually will knock down a whole tree just to eat the fruit, knock down another one just to eat the bark. So they can be really destructive in the forest, but they also help rejuvenate the forest. Their favorite snacks here at Elephant's World are bananas, watermelon, pumpkin, sometimes pineapple, and many different fruits that you and I enjoy too. Here at Elephant's World, they care for many old elephants that have a really hard time chewing their food. They require special diet and special veterinary care. If you ever want to come and see them, it's a great opportunity.